Snestruck.
Thanks to Peter for this request. The Magical Quest starring Mickey Mouse, or Mickey's Magical Quest, which is what I always called it since, you know, it's less syllables, but people still know what you'd be talking about. This was the first Capcom-developed Disney game for Super Nintendo, released in December of 1992, predating later Disney Capcom titles like Aladdin and Goof Troop. This even got a ginormous pull-out Nintendo Power cover signaling that, yeah, this game was going to be a big deal. So how does it hold up today? Mickey's Magical Quest is pretty good, definitely an above-average platformer, but it is a little rougher around the edges, starting first and foremost with the Mickey sprite. There's just something kind of off about the way Mickey looks, especially odd since the Goofy and Pluto sprites look just about dead on. Otherwise, the game looks great. There's six long levels that all have very diverse settings, but nothing out of the ordinary. There's your usual ice level, forest level, and cave levels here. The music also fits the game just fine. It's nothing that's gonna stand out on its own as anything spectacular, but it works for the game. The story is pretty straightforward too. Mickey, Goofy, Donald, and Pluto are all playing catch at the park when Goofy airmails a throw so badly that they all end up in some weird magical land. Jeez, nice going, Goofy. What, is he moonlighting as the Jacksonville Jaguars quarterback under the moniker Blake Bortles? Anyway, in this universe, Mickey's rival Pete is this huge, powerful king, and he's taken Pluto captive just to be a dick, I guess. And it's up to Mickey to find and rescue him. Alright, so how does Mickey's Magical Quest stand out from other platformers, besides the novelty of all the Disney stuff? As you start the game, you might think the answer is nothing, because while the first level looks nice, the Jack and the Beanstalk setting is inspired, it's pretty dull to play through. Mickey's only attack is to jump on enemies to stun them, and then spin them into oblivion. It's kinda cool how you can wipe out lots of other enemies doing this, and you can also spin these tomato things, hold onto them, and fly around. It's not until you get to level 2 when things really get interesting, though, because now Mickey can change clothes. Okay, that's kind of a weird sentence, but that's how it works. This wizard guy grants you this magical outfit, I guess, so Mickey can throw a chargeable projectile. In level 3, you unlock a firefighter outfit with a fire hose you can blast enemies with, and in level 4, you get a mountain climbing getup with a grappling hook. What's really nice is that you can flip through these costumes at will with the L and R buttons, and the level design is arranged so that certain costumes can get you by certain areas, like how the fire hose can move certain blocks away. There's also hidden item shops that allow you to upgrade your costumes by using these coins you can collect throughout each level. So yeah, Mickey's Magical Quest starts out slow, but it gets better and better the deeper you dive into it. Unfortunately, this game isn't that particularly deep, so there's not that much to dive into. Mickey's Magical Quest doesn't provide much of a challenge, which is fine. Sometimes it's fun just to be able to beat a game in one sitting, but even if you've never played this one before, you can pick up a controller cold turkey and get pretty far here, and after you've beaten it once, there's not a lot of replay value. No passwords or battery saves here, by the way, and yeah, this game is technically two-player, but it's alternating turns, no co-op. I have to mention that this game received a remake on the Game Boy Advance that was also developed by Capcom, with Minnie Mouse available as a playable character. Capcom also made a sequel for the SNES titled The Great Circus Mystery starring Mickey and Minnie that'll have to get its own video someday. And there's a third game in the series, Mickey to Donald Magical Adventure 3, that plays very similarly and introduces Donald Duck into the mix as a playable character. Anyway, I do think Mickey's Magical Quest, or The Magical Quest starring Mickey Mouse for all you pedantic folks out there, I do think it's worth playing today. Sure, it's not a huge game with a lot of nuance, and yeah, the Mickey sprite looks a little weird, but this game is up there with stuff like Twinbee, Rainbow Bell Adventure, and Aladdin as just a simple, fun pick-up-and-play platformer that you can complete in an hour. If you somehow missed this one, it's worth checking out, and if you haven't played it in a while, try it out again. It's a quick, fun playthrough.